Good morning and welcome to this service of Taizé chants, prayers and communion from the Hartwell community of the Hartwell and Surrey Hills Churches of Christ. During Taizé services, it is common to light candles. They can be used to mark an emotion or thought that comes during the service and also serve as a focal point while praying or meditating. As I light this candle, I invite you to light a candle of your own at home. I invite you to participate in the service as you feel able, to sing along with the chants, or to simply allow the music to wash over you. In every fragment of time, O God, you work your acts of grace. In every grain of earth, O Christ, you bring your grace to life. In every breath of every living thing, O Spirit, you whisper your grace into our souls. Open our eyes, open our ears, and open our hearts. Open the senses of all people to your ever-present grace, that those who are disillusioned may hope again, that those who are frightened might trust again, that those who despair may rejoice again, that those who grieve and are lost may love again, and that all creation may be filled again with the wonder of your glorious glory. Amen.
You.
Psalm 139, verses 1 to 6, then 13 to 18. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in before and behind and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. I am still with you. We come now into our time of prayer. To begin and end, we will sing, O Lord, hear our prayer twice, and once between each prayer. There will be some time for you to pray aloud or silently for what is on your heart today. O Lord, our God, as we sit in quietness, our thoughts are far from quiet. We are wrestling with doubts and fears. We are looking for answers. We are hoping against hope. We are seeking strength. We are hungry for warm sunshine, for healed bodies, for rest from tears.
Your word says the hungry will be filled, and today we ask for you to fill us. Fill us with the breath of life, fill us with thankful hearts, fill us with calmness, courage, and most of all, with the knowledge of your presence.
There are others we know and love who are ill, and we ask, O God, that you would surround them with your strong, healing presence. Grant wisdom to those who need answers to difficult questions. Grant hope to those who despair, and friendship to those who feel lonely. Most of all, O Lord God, may we know your love, your great love you have for each one. You know the hairs on our head. You count each beat of our heart. You knit us together when we were being formed. You know our getting up and our lying down. You are familiar with all our ways. There is no place we can hide from you. You were there at our beginning, and you will be with us through to the end. May we not lose sight of your constant care.
We look to you, O God, to be present in our communities and in our world. Continue to show us how we in the Hartwell community can be part of your work in the world. Teach us how we can grow into faith and become more and more like Jesus, showing love and acceptance, being inclusive. May we always welcome the stranger and invite them to come and see.
Lord, we lift these prayers, made aloud or silently. We bring to you our lives and our gifts, that they may be used to further your kingdom here and around your world. Amen.
Reading from John chapter 1, verses 43 to 51. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you come to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under a fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man."
We are now coming into our time of communion. Come and see. Philip challenges Nathanael to come and see Jesus, this amazing person who had called Philip to follow him. You can almost hear Jesus laugh in his exchange with Nathanael. You're impressed with this? Just wait and see what else happens. And yes, there were angels, but what also happened was that Jesus showed love, acceptance, and inclusiveness. He saw people for what they really are and invites us to do the same, to show love, to really see people. Here at this table, we remember the great cost paid to show that love, to demonstrate the importance God places on being in relationship with us. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, remember me." Please take your emblems in your own time.
Thank you.
As we come now to the benediction, I invite you to listen or sing with the final chant for as long as you wish. As we leave this place, let us not forget, there is nowhere we can go where God is not. Everywhere we go, God goes before us, from the farthest ocean to the highest mountain, from the heights of joy to the depths of despair. Wherever we find ourselves, God is already there. So go in peace, for we do not go alone.